छोटे से दुनिया का बड़ा सा इंडिया, ये है अपॉर्चुनिटी इंडिया। चाय का प्याला हो या गपशप मिर्च मसाला हो, पैशन है, अग्रेशन है, मिन बात का पैशन है, स्टार्टअप गिरी का फितूर है, अरे तभी तो इंडिया मशहूर है। उम्मीद का सवेरा है, खुशियों का बसेरा है, सपनों का देश, अपनों का देश, यह है अपॉर्चुनिटी इंडिया। मिट्टी में जो हम सपने बोते हैं वो आसमान को छूते हैं, गुडलक की टोपी पहन के भी शीश हमारे झुक जाते हैं। यहां जीत की होती तंग गलियों में तैयारी है और कागज की कश्तियां भी करती किनारों की सवारी है। सपनों का देश, अपनों का देश, ये है अपॉर्चुनिटी इंडिया। यहां आईना है, तस्वीरें हैं, संस्कृति भी खास है, चमकते बाजारों में मुस्कुराता प्यार है, रंग बिरंगी पोशाकों में तभी तो लगते चांद चार है, खुशियां हैं बिहारों की, मिलजुल की बहारों की। सपनों का देश, अपनों का देश, ये है अपॉर्चुनिटी इंडिया। पतंगों के मेलों में कटती रंजिशों की डोर है, सैर है, सपाटे हैं, यहाँ टूरिस्ट बड़े आते हैं। ये मेरा है, ये तेरा है, ओशों का सवेरा है, धूप है, छांव है, उन्नति के गांव है। सपनों का देश, अपनों का देश, ये है अपॉर्चुनिटी इंडिया। पैगामों का इंडिया, हाजिर जवाबों का इंडिया, गुब्बारों में उड़ते आसमानों का इंडिया, कश्ती में सवार निकल पड़ा है इंडिया, पंख फैलाए उड़ चला है इंडिया। सपनों का देश, अपनों का देश, छोटी सी दुनिया का बड़ा सा इंडिया, यह है अपॉर्चुनिटी इंडिया।
Thank you so much, Dheeraj, for the lovely motivational message. Welcome all. With the hope that you all are keeping safe and well at your home, we welcome you to the 34th edition of Business Opportunity with Chai, a webinar series. Yes, Opportunity India. At Franchise India, we truly believe in this concept, and hence, every day with our this initiative, we are providing you opportunity as far as brands are concerned. Today, we are representing you another a new brand, startup brand, and we have a young entrepreneur, Sairam Pratap, who directly comes from Farmer's Best, talking about his journey and giving you all the opportunities he has for you. With this introduction, I request Sai to give us all understanding about your brand, what kind of the value creation you are creating in the market. Thank you so much for sparing time and interacting with our investors. Over to you, Sai. I would request you to please activate your audio, unmute yourself. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Archana, for the intro, and thank you, Gaurav sir and Sonia ma'am, for the opportunity. Myself, Sairam, and founder and managing director of the Farmer's Best. This is basically an organic supermarket. We always want to make it like one-stop destination for all our organic and natural product needs. So basically what we are, I'll give you a small introduction about what we are doing and all. So we have seen a lot of gap between consumer and, you know, organic products, because normally all other products are available in our neighborhoods and, you know, very near locations. All those things are, all other products like chemical farming products or any other products are all available in nearby locations, but especially organic and, you know, natural products are not available to the neighborhoods and very near locations. We need to travel, you know, certain distances to have a certain, that too very limited products are available. So what we thought, we want to make a, you know, supermarket where which give them proper health food and, you know, natural and chemical free foods. So we thought, and so we came with the solution. And we always believe in India, organic is far, you know, distance to the middle class and, you know, the normal 80% of the people which lives in India, which is always believe, you know, it's high rates. And if we can't afford it, so if you want health, you need to put a lot of money into it. So we thought that, no, we'll give them, we believe that, you know, everyone has the right to eat organic food in India, everybody. So on that basis, we always give them the best prices. So which is not like, you know, very, you know, high price. It's always reasonable price where people can afford it. And the same way, there are a lot of gaps in between farmers and the consumers. So if you pay the right price to the farmer, so we can bring the right product to the consumers directly without any middlemen. We can avoid all those pricings, even though we pay the best price to the farmers. So we always pay the best, you know, fair price to farmer as well in that process. And as I said, we want to make it as a one-stop destination for all the consumers to have a, you know, a very good experience of health products. And they can like feel it when they see the store and, you know, when they have the shopping experience. I'll explain how our journey started. Basically, I'm an IT guy. I owned an IT company since 2009. Till 2014, I was the chairman of Arthavedi Information Technologies, which is basically a e-commerce and business intelligence, you know, product development company. Because of pure passion about farming and, you know, organic and all, I left that and I started doing my own farming in my hometown in Andhra Pradesh, more than 100 acres. But it took me really, you know, easy to make farming, organic farming and all. But once it is done, when the product is there in my hand, it's very difficult to sell that product to the consumers. I'm not getting that price or I'm not getting that platform where I can sell my organic stuff to the consumers directly. And people are, there are a lot of gaps in between from consumer to the farmer. So it really, you know, struck me, and I want to have that solution on my hand. And I thought of, you know, understanding it more and more. I travel lot of, you know, areas in south and western part of the India, more than 6 to 7 states, and understood the farmers how they are doing the farming, organic farming in different regions. Everybody have a different methods in different regions. So we try to understand their methods. We try to understand their progress about organic and their marketing issues, how they are feeling and all. So, you know, 80% in India, organic farmers, 80% farmers are selling their product to the mandis only still, because of they don't know where to sell it, whom to sell it in the right way. So either they'll you know, waste it, or they'll sell it to the mandis with very lesser prices, and that product is not coming into as organic. It's mixed with the all other chemical residues. So when I have seen all those things, when I interacted with more than 8,000 farmers and 22 farmer producer organizations and all, we thought as an IT guy, I want to bridge the gap between farmer and consumer. So as a trail and, you know, experiment basis, we started selling all the, in 2016, we started selling all the products through our social media and direct consumer, like, you know, reaching communities, going to the corporates and, you know, informing them how we are bringing the product, how it is, you know, healthier than the other. So we started selling that. Within 6 months, we understood it's possible. People are more interested in organic. We mainly, our focus is to understand the price point, what people are spending and how much money they can spend on organic, and how much gap is there, and, you know, all those things. When we understood all those market areas, we started developing an e-commerce immediately next year. So we came up with the, you know, proper e-commerce platform, Raithurat Online, at 2018, with the app and web and everything. So there we increased our product also. So we started picking a lot of products into it, all grocery, all home requirements into it, fruits and vegetables and all. So we slowly, you know, without any any advertisement, you don't believe, without any advertisement, not even 1,000 rupees on, you know, marketing and all, we reached 7,000 customer base within 1 year. And I used to get orders 150 to 200 every day, and still going on with only mouth publicity. We grown into the next level. So once we thought and everything is, people are more interested into organic and a lot of orders are coming into it. We again thought there is a gap between the, you know, organic and consumer, as they are not feeling the product in right way. Like, why this product we need to buy? Why, how it's do it, it my better way and all. So we thought of having a retail store that will give them an experience where they can walk in and they can feel it, what the product is exactly, and they can purchase everything, you know, whatever they needed there. Then we came up with the retail store solution, and 2020 January we started our first store in Hyderabad, and immediately we have got very, very good response. It's just a small store, around 900 to 1100 square feet. First month itself, we are into profitable. We got around 37,000 rupees of profit immediate month. And when the COVID, immediate next month, COVID lockdown and the situation started, we thought of disturbance will happen, but the rise is going on and on and on, because people are, they are even, you know, standing in queues for 1/2 kilometer to procure the product. I'm not keeping my, you know, vegetables and fruits, not even a half day. Whenever I bring the product, within half day, my product is getting sold out. Lot of people are even coming into, you know, my stores, lot of new customers, when they, you know, came to know about the this thing and all. Even lot of people are started asking about franchises. So they want to have their own stores and all. So luckily we already closed 3 outlets. Most probably within next 3-4 months, we'll open another 3 outlets in Hyderabad itself. So a lot of people are converting into organic because of the COVID as well. That's how we started our journey and things. And how we work, basically, as I'm already given a glimpse of, you know, thing earlier. Basically, we work with the farmers directly because of, we are basically farmer oriented. We always believe, all these companies build on total market research and how implementation and all those things. So we help them in a better production and planning and organic methods or bio inputs, post-harvest marketing strategies, how to keep their product sustainable for a longer period of time. And when with all those things, we'll help them to keep it on the better quality and sell it on the right price to the right consumer. Not only farmer produce, we need all range of other byproducts also to bring into the market so that we can cover that gap very easily. So we started working on byproducts of all agriculture things. There are few institutions we are working with them, and we are bringing the right product into the our portfolio. And even we pay some, you know, good price to them. We believe that we are doing it for the environment safe and better practices for the future. And with all those things, we are making this one as a one-stop destination. Like all our like organic needs, like not only fruits, vegetables, and grocery, we can cover it up. All like baby foods or any dishwashers or floor cleaners. Or body cares or personal care products, we can cover all range of organic and natural products at very affordable prices to the consumers. This is the market scope. Actually, we all know that we are all eating chemical residues. Like, you know, we know every farmer, almost 98% of farmers in India are doing farming with pesticides and synthetic fertilizers. So in recent days, even government also showing a lot of interest about organic, and they are also giving some encouragements, and they are giving some technology to the, you know, farmer groups that they're encouraging a lot of farmers converting into organic. Last 2 years back, Andhra government came up with a ZBNF concept. So with zero budget natural farming, lots of farmers in Andhra are converted into organic. They are doing with the ZBNF method. And it's a very more and more properties coming with very less investments. So automatically price will come down when we put a lot of money into farming, organic farming, and we're not getting a lot of production, harvest product, then price will go high. But in this method, people are doing very good results with low investment and a very good descent of, you know, harvest. So a lot of farmers are having awareness of organic now, and a lot of people are coming into organic, and we are helping them to have the right mind and right process with all our manpower and whatever technology we understood since last 6 years. And health awareness in the industry as well. We know one of the most learnings from these people from this COVID, you know, during this time, we know that, you know, we need to build strong immunity to fight against these type of deadly viruses. So organic food, being, you know, full of antioxidants and nutrients, provides best ways to, one of the best ways to, you know, have that immunity in ourselves directly. And instead of taking risk, people also started, even for the even little extra price also, they want to have the organic food now. Lot of people are converting into now. And coming to the conversion rate, one of, you know, research and statistics, research organizations given some things in last March. Next 1-2 years, minimum 30-40% of people are converting into organic. Consumers are going to convert into organic in next 1-2 years. That will give us a lot of scope and lot of we'll be more happy, like, you know, more people into getting awareness, and, you know, more people coming into organic. And coming to the leader, there are few agencies working for organic product. There are few companies are working on organic product, but there is no proper market leader in India where we will get all range of products comfortably. If you step into a store, you feel that you will have a right good for your babies, your baby food, or you need a good product for your kitchens, like kitchen cleaners or floor cleaners or detergents for our cloths, or any byproducts. Like what we are doing since last 6 months is we started working on byproducts as well. Like I always believe that not only grocery will change people's eating habits. So we can't change people eating habits very easily. So we need to give them the same sort of food without any chemicals. Then only we can convert them in even much easily. And they also, you know, understood why we need to pay and how it's going to help us out. So the same taste, same food, will give them chemical free. So why Farmers Best? Farmers Best is, since last 3-4 years, we are growing very rapidly with just only 4 products. Today we have around 200 SKU with all range of organic products. So that too, we are not customer oriented, like we are into consumer oriented or any, you know, branded oriented. We are into farmers oriented. So we are bringing most of the good products from farmers, and we are make sure that they're getting the right product to the, you know, right places. And as I already told, our prices are more affordable than any other reputed brand in India. We always believe organic food is everyone's right. So everyone should have that food they can eat in their homes comfortably. So our product is completely affordable, and which is not, if compared to any other normal product, good brand, which is hardly 20% higher than the rate. If you compare to any other organics, we are cheaper than any other organics in India. And we always believe not in franchises, like, you know, we believe like a partner. So we realize that the total this growth is depends on the, you know, any franchise growth depends on our own growth as well. So we always work with them. We always make sure we'll do the right marketing and, you know, right way of presenting the product, and we'll bring them the right product to the people, consumers as well. So we work with them like a partner, and we make sure we are going to be in a successful note. And supply chain, the most important thing in this company, what we understood and we build is a well-matured and robust and diversified supply chain. So since last 6 years, we are working with a lot of FPOs, lot of farmers. It's always a bit difficult to, you know, make sure everybody is on the right note and, you know, bringing the product right time. So we work with them. We make sure we always have that, you know, schedules and all. Make sure that, you know, they'll give the product in the right manner. So that supply chain we already built. We have a decent collection units throughout South India, and we have a processing units. So where we'll you know, bring the product to anywhere in South India very, very comfortably. The establishment flow. Any investors are interested to, you know, invest on this. First, they need to come up with an ideal location. So we help them to have identifying the right location for them, because we always believe neighborhood stores works very well in this system. Whenever especially for women, if the store is available in the, you know, walkable distances, our sales will grow high automatically. So identifying the location is very, very important. And once location is identified, we'll start with the paperwork and payment processing. Once it is done, we'll hand over the location. When we start working on the makeover, within 45 days, we'll make over the store and we'll keep it ready for the launch. So before launch itself and after launch also, we'll give technical support and software support. We have our own software. We were working with one of the agency of the software, and so we have a decent software which have all the features, and we are integrating our e-commerce also into it, so that any nearby location, any orders comes through online or e-commerce also, will direct to the store, so store can supply those deliveries as well. And ongoing marketing solutions and the product support also. We are already working on a lot of new products. We want to convert all packaged foods in every possible manner, make it without any chemical and without any chemical preservatives. So we are already working on that. Very, very few and few months we are coming up with new products continuously. So we'll cover most of the product range, whatever has in India, we'll convert them into organic very soon. These are the investment models, which starts with the, you know, compact one, 750 square feet to 900. And this, whatever the franchise investment, is inclusive of product and makeover charges. So every store will supply all the product range. So products with a makeover, that is the cost which we have investment. And which may vary depending on the locations also. Some locations, depends on the area of the location, or depends on the size, dimensions of the locations. So costings will vary accordingly. This agreement is for 5 years, and we're not charging any royalties or anything. Renewal fee, we are not decided. We can have it in the future. And we are giving a solution for ice creams and cold pressed juices also, because we are working on organic fruits and vegetables and all, leafies and all. So without wasting them, we can convert into a proper healthy juice bar, where people can have a small sit out area, and they can have a fresh juice, cold pressed one, with their choice of sugars, because we have a lot of sugar options with us, coming to the palm sugar, coconut sugar, and brown sugar. And whatever their choice, we can give them options, and without sugar also. So we already working on that juices one. We are launching our new store in Manikonda, Hyderabad, which is having ice cream kiosk and cold pressed juice kiosks as well there. So, but we need space. So we are giving those options, mid and large part of the stores. In this thing, what we do and what we need from the franchisee is, we give them some geographical territory, right? It depends on the location, premises, 600 to 900 square feet, will give nearby 1.5 kilometer territory, right? And if it is a bigger store, we'll give them 3 kilometers of geographical right. and any orders in between, and online also we direct to them only, and we make sure we deliver the, you know, your store in within 45 days, and all trainings of you to, you know, even manpower also, to get the manpower and training them, make sure understanding the organic, because our experience says this product cannot sold themselves. We need to explain the product. So we need right person in the store to understand the product, who can explain it much better way to the consumers, so that people can easily buy it. And we take care of all the responsibilities of supplying goods to the, you know, stores, and any expiries, any damages, we'll take care. Franchise need not to worry about it, and we'll give them the new product without any cost. And only whenever new product releases, or you know, any new events we are doing, we'll take care of all promotions, you know, in higher level. But store nearby location, franchisee has to handle the, you know, small marketing, like, you know, no parking boards, or, you know, small pamphlets. We'll supply them the materials, and they need to take care of the near location marketing things. So franchise has to be handle the advances of real estate and their rentals, power bills, or any miscellaneous, and staff salaries, operational expenses, all those things borne by the franchisee only. And as I said, within nearby area and store premises, any marketing things will be handled by the franchisee. And wastage of vegetables and fruits and dairy also handled by the franchisee only, because if we are not keeping it on the right manner, we always guide them to make sure they're keeping it on the right way and displaying on the right manner. And we also give as based on the sale only, we supply the goods so that they'll not waste much vegetables and fruits. So we help them. We make sure, they'll not waste much into it. But the responsibility of waste handling is franchisee. And so for different locations, you know, remote locations, it's difficult for us to have a store or something. We ship from here to the nearby godowns there. So if any remote location franchises, they need to pick up the product from the nearest warehouses when needed. These are the product ranges we have currently, from, you know, rice, dals, grains, flours, cold pressed oils, spices, masalas, dry fruits, virgin coconut oils, olive oils, ghee, and different types of millets and millet snacks also we are bringing. Salt, sugar, lot of sugars are there, jaggery powders, honey, and some beverages. And we are coming up with cold pressed beverages also. Mostly next 3 months we are launching a new product on beverages, and cool drinks, packaged foods, ready mixes. So all these things are chemical free and with organic ingredients. We are working with a few dairy farmers also. We are giving them the right ingredients, you know, right feed to feed the buffaloes and all, to without using any other steroid based injection or something. So we are working with them, and we are bringing the right product in dairy as well. And in hair care, skin care, oral, personal, detergents, floor cleaners, toiletries, these also we are working with a natural, total natural ingredients. Since last 2-3 months, we are working on bubble nut based cleaners and all, which is working very well. On an average, we are giving special margins to the franchisees around 22-40%. It varies depending on the product range. And as it's a commodity, the product margins will vary month by month also. But on an average, it will be like 22-40%. We'll give them. So if you have any queries, and we can.
Thank you, Sahib. This is fabulous. I think you are a young man, but already done 2 successful enterprises, one your IT business, now running an organic business. And I think a lot of entrepreneurs don't follow their heart. So I think you followed your heart and did what you wanted to do.
I think
farming is something which is not, I see a lot of young entrepreneurs taking, but I feel that it's a tremendous opportunity, especially on the organic side, and there is a lot of opportunities from farming to supply chain to direct to home to the whole integration of farm to the homes is a tremendous opportunity. A lot of value is actually lost in between that.
We're not audible.
I'm not audible. So, so I feel that a lot of value is lost between from where I call from the farm produced to when it reaches homes. A lot of value is lost. So there is a lot of opportunity, and I always encourage young entrepreneurs to really come there, because in last 20-25 years we have seen all the young people who were even coming from farming backgrounds of family and things like that, they've all moved to urban environments, and nobody is really going back to farming and industry and so on and so forth. And it's a very large industry, and I feel that there is a bigger opportunity for all of us to really capture that opportunity. So I would like to start with a little bit on giving you a perspective on terms of how the organic industry is really looking like, because we have been actually working with a lot of players which are organic players, and I found that a lot of them have supply chain issues, consistency of produce issues. A lot of times they have, because it's always going to be seasonal, so you don't really have a lot of products which are non-seasonal products. And as a consumer, we are now actually forgotten what comes in what season. So we try to expect that we will get 12-month supply, and organic never does that. So give me a little bit on understanding of how organic farming is shifting, and how much is the size today from a produce and the, because a lot of time retailers, when you become a franchisee, if I become a franchisee, I need to know that, is the supply chain consistent? Are we getting the right kind of supplies coming through? And is this, and how many stores currently you would be able to feed? So my question is really, give a little bit of insight of the size of the market, how it is changed, how it is maturing, especially the farms which you are working on. Second, current capacity of yours, how many stores you would be able to feed with the current size and capacity you hold? Over to you. And give a little bit perspective on how organic certification also. I know a lot of people are claiming organic, but they're not organic. So what is happening on that? So a little bit on the industry and a little bit on the size of capability you've already built in.
Thank you, sir. So normally we started this business from there onwards, because normally a lot of businesses starts their retail stores or product, then they start working on their supply chain. But what I did is we started from there, from sources. So we went to the farmers' places and we understood their capacity, how they are farming and how they are building their product down there, unable to market it. So when we understood all the product line, we directly not came into the retail immediately. So we again came to the industry and how often we can bring the product, how often we can supply the product comfortably, and at what quality we can supply. So we already worked on those areas since last 3-4 years. And at this point of time, we are since 2016 to now, even from my end, almost all 5,000 to 6,000 farmers are converted into organic. Even more and more people are coming into organic. We are working with the Telangana government also. Like Telangana government is giving a very good benefit for organic farmers who wants to have a certificate. So for Ekra, only 10 rupees cost they're taking, and they're giving that certificate process. They're helping them to get certified in a very easy manner. So certification is also not that costly thing now. So it came to a very affordable price. People are, a lot of farmers also now averting that, because using of pesticide, they are getting cancers. In every village, whenever I traveled, there are a few farmers who is affected by the cancers because of the pesticides which they are, keep putting on the farms. So in that manner also, slowly people thought, farmers thought process also changing towards organic. Now at this point, at this situation, we can comfortably supply more than 100 stores continuously throughout the year, because as I said, in India, 80% organic farmers produce are going into mandis, because there is no proper platform where we can sell this organic product as organic. So they are bringing these products into mandis and they are getting the same price which they are getting for any other product also. So we are helping them to avoid that situation and converting into a proper a platform between the farmer and consumer, where we can give the right product to the consumers also. And even this, even we do a lot of, you know, educating farmers, or, you know, doing some seminars and make sure they're doing the right thing. Few farmers, as we know, did some mistakes towards farming, you know, chemical thing and all those things. So what we're doing is we are testing our product randomly in every month for the chemical residues in the product as well. Sometimes they may not see, even intentionally or unintentionally, sometimes what happens, they'll spray something which is not used to, you know, spray on the farm. So we make sure we are delivering the right product to the farm consumers all the time. Not only farmers' point of view, we make sure, because as a brand, we are taking responsibility. We are climbing something, we are giving you healthy fruit. It's our responsibility. Make sure we are giving them the right food. So we are working with laboratories in Hyderabad, and we randomly check few samples, and we make sure there is no chemical residues. Even though if it is, it should be under the organic levels. And coming to the production level, sir, lot of product is exported from India now. Organic, especially because here people are unable to afford the price. So a lot of people are sending this product to the, you know, exporters. The farmer is not getting the price. Here, whatever the middleman people who is exporting the product, they are getting the benefits. But farmer is still having the same sort of prices, same way. So we are helping in that manner also. We are saying that no need to export it. When there is no proper middleman, you are directly selling to the consumer. We just work on the middle to have the decent retailer margin. You are the manufacturer and you can supply product to the consumer. We just act as a retailer all the time. So we are working on that segment, and we proudly we are successful since last 4-5 years comfortably. And we are making a lot of villages also into, you know, organic now. That agenda is going on now after this COVID and all. We want to have a model village where complete village converted into organic.
That's very helpful, and I will go to the, so to say, a little more deeper into your business model, and first try to explain us in terms of what is the consumer side. You know, is consumer going to pay extra money for organic product? And if yes, what is the difference? What kind of price point a consumer has to pay more? Second, I saw you are giving a lot of margin also to the retailer, to the franchisee, which is 22-40%. And that's very high, you know, in FMCG, you don't get this kind of margin. Is this margin coming because you're charging higher to the consumer, or it is coming because you have no middleman and you're taking the entire distribution margin? And that would take my third question. If you take out that distribution margin, who handles distribution? You know, are you putting distribution centers, especially when you go outside Hyderabad and say you go to Chennai and other markets, would you put a distribution center and that cost would be done? Would bring in a more pressure on pricing? So these are my three questions. And on further to that, on your rollout, because a lot of people are asking from all over India, and we have one of the largest groups joined in and shows their interest in the whole category. So I would like to know which markets you would be ready in what phase, because it's a lot of logistic issue. You might not be able to do all markets at this stage, maybe South India to begin with, and then go to other things, because people are asking from Punjab, they're asking from other regions. So my question on extension of a business model, consumer price point, explain us that a little bit on the margins, in the franchisee margin, how it is so much margin you are able to do, and do you think this margin would continue for years to come, or it'll go as you have other cost going on, your distribution capability, and fourth is your rollout.
Sure, sir. First, price point, sir, we are lesser compared to any other reputed organic brands in India, because we already avoided a lot of middlemen in between. Because there will be an agent in between from farmer to the any reputed brand. From agent to, it will go to the manufacturer's unit, and they'll manufacture and they'll supply to the distributors, like then wholesalers, then retail stores, or somewhere directly distributed to retailers also. So when we are avoiding all those in between channels, we are the only one in between from consumer to the farmer. So we are giving the best price to the consumers. And people also, the price point, what we are...
Give me one example of 1 kg of something would cost in a non-organic is so much, in your store is so much. What is the price difference for a consumer and something which is very fast moving?
Sure. Like Tur Dal. Take an example of Tur Dal. Any reputed non-organic Tur Dal also, they are selling it for 140 to around 150 rupees in outside. Any other normal retail store outside, you know, they are selling it for 120 to 110 rupees. We are selling it for, there are two varieties I have, a premium variety and a normal variety. 160 rupees the normal variety and 180 rupees is the premium variety which we are selling now. And when they are spending 150 to 160 on a normal quality product, and for organic 180 rupees is not a big deal, the 20-25% of extra, they are ready to afford it. And you don't believe, sir, in the last 1 month, we sold around 700 kgs of Tur Dal very much easily. So people are, they're not feeling bad about paying the 20% or 25% when they're getting the right product. So, other brands also, there are some other organic brands which are selling. Most probably an average price point is more than 200. So average price point. So we are even lesser than that. We are doing very good job at that area. And coming to the distribution model, sir, we are not ready to do it pan India now. As you said, it's a big, very big supply chain. We need to work around. We thought in different manner. The South India has we have an outlet where we are planning in between all those four states. It's like, you know, in Andhra, Nelluru to Anantapur districts. In between, we are planning a big production house where we can ship throughout South India in just 300-400 kilometers radius. So that is not a big problem for us. We'll directly bring from the farmer there and we'll do all the processing and manufacturing there. And we supply from there to all cities comfortably. And so I don't need any other distributors in between for South India currently. That's why we are concentrating on South India now at this point of stage. Once this COVID situation overs, we want to expand it to North India also. Where we need a lot of even farmer groups, and we are working with a lot of farmer groups. I have a big schedule on March, which I'm unable to do because of the COVID. If I would have gone there, we have come up with a lot of options also. So we are working with few farmer groups there also from Rajasthan and Gujarat as well, because Rajasthan is working very, very rapidly on organic level. We already working with few farmers there. So we make sure that, in next phase, after 6 months or so, we can expand this business into the North India as well. Once this COVID situation stabilizes, we can start working around that.
Sure. And it is also, this is my advice to you also and for a lot of other players. If you feel them synergy, even in other areas like West Bengal or East India or Punjab or entire thing, this is the right time they can come and join with you. If they have synergy, they can maybe become a bigger partner with you to create not necessarily sometime franchise, but maybe a joint venture where you bring in all the knowledge of what you've done. They bring in their local strengths and capability. And I think the possibilities can emerge. This is a time of collaboration. In times of collaboration, one should be open both for investments, because your business would continue to need more investment. You need to have a franchise partners, and you can also have some joint venture partners. Partners also very good, because hey, if I was in state of Rajasthan and I want to do, say, I see an opportunity of 50 stores in Rajasthan, but I don't have a technology, I don't have the knowledge, so you can bring all that, and somebody can bring in an early capital a little bit, and then you can start an independent joint venture company in Rajasthan, and that's how I think in a collaborative environment your business can grow much faster in state by state. And rather than losing opportunity and waiting opportunity to go to somebody, because a lot of other companies are also eyeing to get into organic farm to home direct market kind of a capability. So there's a lot of work which you have done in last 5-6 years, and that all work can translate into much faster expansion. So I would like to now Sonia for her remarks and taking some lot of questions, because a lot of questions are coming in and we don't want to disappoint any any of our listeners that we cover all the major questions. Sonia, over to you, please.
Thank you. I'm not too sure on my connection. It's going on and off. While most of the answers, we have kind of answered many of the questions which have been raised, were primarily as far as the supply chain was concerned and the locations, but as we have seen on giving awarding franchisee in. We can pick up any questions that we feel are relevant, but just to give my perspective on the business, I think overall grocery as a market is one of the highest repeat cases as far as urban consumer is concerned. And as far as the Indian organic market is concerned, it is growing and we have favorable policies from the government, which you also mentioned. And there's a increase or rising land area under organic cultivation as we speak today. And there's a good interest of the investors. Also globally, the market size is increasing. It starts from North America and Asia happens to be the third market as far as organic products are concerned. And one of the major concerns as far as this category is concerned is that of supply chain, and especially from the small and mid-sized farmers, which becomes very difficult for them to access the market, so to say. And I would say a little bit efficient when it comes to sustainability, it comes to quality control, it comes to traceability of the product, which I feel is very important in these times where consumers is very keen to know where the product is coming from. So traceability, I would say, is very important parameter today. And the growing consciousness of sustainability and global today also expect the brands to support a lot of social and environmental issues. Now, my, maybe I'll take up some questions which are currently put in. And there's one question which I tried to answer, Sai, but I would want that if you could take it up. There's somebody who's talked about availability of a farm in Ahmedabad. And he says, if there is some kind of a model that you can work with him, he does not want a franchisee, but he has a land which is available. And I'm sure a lot of people from Haryana, Punjab, who are also on this webinar might have that. Do you think any kind of integration happening with the people who have farm and some kind of tie-up can be done for organic farming and further, the products could be sourced from them and supplied to the platform or retailers, your franchisees?
We can work with the farmers. We are already doing that in southern states. But working Ahmedabad and Haryana will take some time, but we can give them better model and how to do the organic farming in a very rightful manner, because we don't want to waste any single inch of land. We give them a modern farming, like within two acres, you can cultivate 30 vegetables which are needed for the organic stores. Like, we'll give them best practices to them. Normally, farmers, what they do is they'll cultivate in 2 acres, 3 acres, or 4 acres, a single crop. So whenever the harvest is ready, they'll come up with 1 tons, 2 tons, or 3 tons of quantities immediately. That is difficult to sell in this organic segment. So what we suggest them is, if you have a 2 acres or 3 acres farm, you make sure you have a proper intervals between the plantations, and make sure every week you harvest at least 20 to 30 varieties of vegetables, which is possible, which we are already doing in southern states. So every week you give the shopper, retailers, or any distributors only 30 kg or 50 kg of each crop, so which will become like a 1 ton again, but that is more sustainable one, where they'll get money every week very comfortably, which will not get waste. Even retailer will take it immediately, because 30 kgs is not a big deal for them. They can purchase it from the farmer as well. So like that, we are encouraging farmers to have the right model. And in that 2-3 acres farm itself, they can have a multiple, intercropping, like in the edges of, there are raw bananas or, directly bananas or papaya. So they can have a 10 to 20, plants here and there. That is also give them extra money when they are selling that product to the consumer, retailers. So that's why we can help them to have the better model, better farming standards. But currently collaborating with Haryana and Ahmedabad will take some time, as we are concentrating on southern states now. If they have any grocery items like dals or pulses, spices or anything, which we can help them out, how to market it, how to, keep it ready, do the organic and certification process. In that manner, we can help them out.
Longer shelf life, not perishables. Yeah, okay. All right. Another question I had while we talked about the pulses and the price difference between organic and the non-organic. We have a question from one of the prospects who also wants to understand the price differentiation between the vegetables also. What is the percentage of difference between organic and non-organic?
It depends on the product actually in vegetables particularly because I'll tell you, especially in summer seasons, you will not get product in every city. So whichever is not available in the nearby in city areas, which will cost them extra. Like suppose take carrot or beetroot. Currently for Hyderabad, carrot beetroot is coming from Ooty. So which is too far from here, the transportation cost will be high at this point of time. Product will be available all over the 365 days. But price point at this, especially in summer, suppose outside is 50 rupees. Here it will become like 75 rupees or 80 rupees because of the non-availability and transportation will take extra charge. But when things will become normal, automatically price will come down to 60. So hardly the same way, 25 to 40% variation in the vegetables also. Some vegetables we are selling even cheaper also. Suppose tomato and onion this season we sold for only 25 rupees and 30 rupees organic one. So it always, you know, vice versa. Few we can sell even cheaper rates than the organic. Suppose you can take example of cold pressed oils also. We are selling organic cold pressed oils for $295, where all other normal cold pressed oils are costing at $300. Like we give them better rates also. Even wheatgrass powder, flax seeds, we are giving them much cheaper than any organic, any other non-organic products also. Because people are, we are not working on those, you know, higher margin things. We'll take decent margin, which is, you know, sustainable. And we'll give them the benefit to consumer as well because they are right to spend that money, right money to the right product.
Okay, another question I had, you know, because I see an integration, you also have an online portal. I see somebody putting it and, you know, while he was checking. So you have an online portal and you also run physical stores. And online has no geographies. You can supply anywhere. What kind of a role would a physical store have in case of a online sales happening in that region? Will you have any role to play? Online is completely handled by the company.
Your voice is breaking in between. I don't know the exact question. I'll tell you. So we have an online system, but we are integrating that online into the stores as well. Like as we are giving territorial right to the, you know, stores, in any order comes from their region, we'll give that order to the store only. So they are the right people to deliver it on time. And we have a scheduled based deliveries also because currently we are working on a schedule model for vegetables and fruits. We only bring fresh produce on Wednesdays and Saturdays so that we can control the product wastage and quality of the product also. So in these 2 days, people are already giving orders before Monday for the Wednesday order, for Saturday on the Wednesday. So same orders we direct to the shop owner only. So franchise has to deliver those products to the consumers.
Sure, thank you. So the next question from your side.
If you can just give a, you know, you have talked about the four models that you run. What kind of throughput from a typical store can one expect is one of my questions. The other is how much a store would need a subscriber base. You know, some are orders which come online, which can be new users. But what is the percentage of a typical subscriber who takes from the outlet? Just to understand between the two, how much focus goes and revenue comes from these two customer base.
Yeah, that I can tell you. Actually, a small store, they can comfortably do sale around 4 lakh to 6 lakh rupees in a month. The biggest plus point of this industry is they are repeated customers. They'll come back for you every alternate day for either fruits or vegetables or dairy or any product. And my repeated customer conversion is almost 69%. Since last 2 years, we are almost on the say average of 57 to 69% repeatedly. So people are coming back again and again to purchase the product. An average purchase point for the each consumer is around 3,000 to 4,500 rupees for grocery, around 2,000 rupees on vegetables. One single customer can purchase in a month. So on an average, even though you are getting 300 or 500 people, around 300 to 500 customers also, you can easily convert those numbers comfortably. And we are giving them very higher margin products in few things, where they'll, like bigger stores, we are offering them cold pressed juices and organic ice creams, which will give them more and more profitable, like, you know, they can reduce the wastage of fruits, and they can higher their margins comfortably in doubling, tripling their margins. And in ice creams also, they have more than 40% margins. So it have a very high shelf life. Without one single person, you can easily sell 10,000 rupees per day in ice creams. And juices also, you can do around 5,000 to 8,000 rupees per day, which is, it's a very profitable one for highest stores.
Somebody asked you a question, Sonia, so you can just take the question and please take that question.
Would you mind to ask, there's a question from one of our investors. He wants to understand is it possible to run an organic store in tier 2 and tier 3 city? If yes, then what would be the investment and how to market there?
Yeah, I'll tell you one good important. Yesterday, I have a very big discussion with one of the investor from Telangana. He wants to have the stores in three cities, which are two-tier cities. So not only from there, I'm getting a lot of calls from two-tier and three-tier cities also. Because of COVID, a lot of people are converting into organic in respective towns as well. Because even a lot of people are went to their hometowns now. And they're planning come back or not, we don't know. But a lot of people are converting into organic, even in small towns and, tier 2, tier 3 cities as well. So coming to the investment point, automatically investment will come down as real estate prices and rentals and salaries of the employees or investment on the store will come down in the tier 2 and tier 3 cities because of the lesser cost there. And price point, the people are ready to spend that money because we are not charging very high price. Spending 1500 rupees or 2000 rupees extra than normal provisions. A lot of people are interested in it, and when we are delivering the right product.
Excellent. So, we are getting a lot of inquiries and answers coming through. People are obviously very interested on this category, and I can tell you with 34 different webinars we've done, this is one of the most interested ones, because for obvious reasons people have understood that this is a category which is going to be the future.
Right.
And also sustainable farming, organic farming, chemical-free food is our necessity, especially in country like India. Chemicals started because we were a poor nation. We wanted to produce a lot, so fertilizers were used and so on and so forth. And we stayed in the same technology, which is a very primitive technology, and I would call it a fertilizer mafia, which continued to not change our farming methodologies and so on.
Right.
I think there is an ability now with technology and professionals like you. I like you, like, because you are like an IT thing, IT professional, because your studies are in IT, so you're a precision guy. Everything is numbers to you. How much I repeat customer and so on and so forth. So if we are able to bring entrepreneurs like you who come from technology and come and change the way old practices of farming can change, I think it is a multi-billion dollar opportunity coming in. Why we should get organization like Cargill, which is one of the largest companies in the world, come down to India and do farming here? Why can't our own entrepreneurs really create large farming enterprises and so on and so forth? And so we are getting a lot of people writing from different states also. There's a gentleman written from Maharashtra. There is somebody who's written from Jharkhand. There is somebody who's writing from other parts of the country. And they're all exploring to partner with you. So my humble suggestion would be that while in South India, you can start franchising and keep your stores. In other markets where you need a local partner, also explore joint ventures. Explore licensing, kind of an opportunity where you do what you've done in 6, 7, 8 years. Go and actually help them to carve that entire thing, build credible partnerships, so they become your partner in that state, work on expanding that state and so on and so forth. So it can grow faster. Anyway, I feel that the farming itself is a very collaborative function. It's a very cooperative function.
Right.
I know in markets like Europe, Italy, and places like that, there is a cooperatives which actually work and collaborate all the other farmers and then go out and take the market produce, and they manage the brand and they manage the fair pricing and fair sales structures, a lot of technology. So India needs that. India would, this would help consumer get the honest food, and it will also help a lot of entrepreneurs in different parts of India to get a very sustainable and a good business. So if some of more questions, Sonia, you see, we want to take up or we can organize some of the one-on-one discussions as we go along. You're on a mute, Sonia.
I think we can do one-on-one with some specific cases, but I see more or less we have covered all the questions. Most of them were related to the locations that they could open, and some were related to the supply chain. And the ROI is one question. I'm not too sure if we covered that because my connection was unstable. How many months or what is the timeline for somebody to break even one? And what is the typical ROI for the stores?
Which will take 2.5 years to 3 years comfortably, an average for right location. Even it will cover below 2 years also, before 2 years as well. And very good location, very higher products, like what when I said ice creams and cold presses juices. If you have those type of things also, you will cover it even 2 years also, because those are higher margin products. You can cover your investment very, very much fast. So it depends on the area and right location. It will varies to the, you know, below 2 years to 3 years.
While you have actually taken all the investment into CapEx and you're giving return on the CapEx and do a return on investment on that. But in a business like yours, I would like to put only the interiors in the CapEx and the stock, because stock is not risk. End of the day, it's a commodity. It has depreciation, no loss of product and so on and so forth. So it should go into your OPEX. So fundamentally, to answer the right part, the CapEx return can come much, much faster because it doesn't require too much of investment. Rest, you are putting stocks, and stocks are vegetables, fruits, ghee. All these things have no risk, so to say. Even if you want to exit, why I like businesses like this, if you want to tomorrow exit the business, you can exit in one day. You can sell the entire stock in one single day. That's why this business is very interesting, because it has no dead stocks. It's not like fashion or other things where you can have stuck with stock and things like that. So it's a clean model. If your CapEx is only the basic interiors, and he's done it very intelligently. One, it gives a very warmth and gives a very good combination of being an organic store. And it is a low CapEx. It's not so much of big CapEx. So that's my advice on this. So we would like to take your final remarks and Sonia's final remarks, and our teams are writing consistently. We're getting queries and we will reach out to each one of them and start organizing one-on-one meetings with you. And especially our Hyderabad team would work aggressively on this to make sure that we reach out. We have a lot of consultants all over India, which are our IFCs and our BN partners. They all would also work with you to bring their clients to your side, and depending on the compatibility of these clients with you and your framework, in both in investment, JV or a franchise, new partnerships can emerge. So remarks from you, Sonia, and Sai from you. Sai, can you any remarks from you?
So thank you so much for the opportunity, and I'm glad that we are presenting this to the through Franchise India, that as we want to, you know, bring lot of people into organic. So our aim is to have organic in every household. It's every birthright in Indians. So that's what we feel. So we work towards that aim. So with help of you, we make sure we reach our aims very soon. And thank you so much for the opportunity.
Thank you so much. I would say, you know, people have today started looking for organic products for themselves as well as for their children, kids. They've started
giving for the next generation.
Yeah. So, and I would say, given the kind of innovation and coupled with the rising demand that we are seeing, the industry is yet to witness the full-fledged evolution. But I feel we can all safely assume the organic food sector is here to stay increasing. And all the people who have queries, they can also see the recent reports from SOCHM and many other associations who put across the reports of how the industry is growing and increasing. So we're all here to work with you, Sai, and help you grow within South and eventually Pan India. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. We still have a lot of questions. We apologize if you're not able to take all the questions, but we will capture each inquiry. And our teams would work hard to make sure that every single inquiry is answered. And we will organize a maximum tri-party call with Sai. And he's available. He's committed us that he will put the next week with us in terms of this whole week and the next week to really reach out and address more and more queries. And Archana, final thank you word from your side.
Sure, Gaurav sir. So thank you so much, everyone. Thank you so much, all the attendees, participants who have joined us. You shared all your questions to us. Most of them are answered, but definitely as suggested by Gaurav sir and Sonia ma'am, we'll definitely get back to you. You can call us, write to us, or you can follow us as per the information given in chat tool. There are numbers given, there are email IDs and social links given to you. We'll definitely love to come back to you with all your queries. You can also follow Gaurav sir and Sonia ma'am through their LinkedIn profile. The information is there on your screen. Thank you so much, Sai, for taking our time and giving us this particular opportunity and interacting with all our investors. Thank you so much, Gaurav sir, Sonia ma'am, sharing your insights, sharing your feedback and suggestion for all our investors, for brand and for all of us. But before we leave tomorrow, again, a great brand for each one of you, Magnify. It's not only a franchisee, but a franchisee and investment opportunity with world's first social commerce O2O marketplace platform. It's a web and mobile e-commerce market aggregator. Do not miss this chance to interact with Vikram, who is the co-founder and CPO for this particular brand.
We're also launching now investment opportunity. And the investment opportunity means...
Gaurav sir, I'll just bother you here. You are a bit far from your mic.
So we are also launching now a special initiative where we are not only the franchise opportunity, but also opportunity if you want to be investor in the early startups. So we see a lot of progressive startups available, which are great. And if you feel that you want to be investing into that startups, so you can also reach us. And because these are times where we are encouraging collaborative function, where I think the progress of any enterprise is continuous capital raise. And also for a lot of our investors would like to get share out of the parent company because they are part of the value creation rather than just being investing as a franchise. So tomorrow's opportunity is also both for franchise and investment opportunity. It's a multi-buying platform, a very high technology, they're already operational. And we would like to see you tomorrow. Even in Farmer Fresh, Best, while he's not open up his equity at this stage, but if you have an investment opportunity or you are an investor and you look at some investment opportunity, we can obviously take it to my end. Thank you.
Thank you so much, everyone. Once again, our best wishes to each one of you. Please do take good care of yourself and your health and your family. Thank you so much. All the best for the rest of the day.